advertisement by data warehouse. So data warehouse is having many definitions. The prescribed definition is in 1990, Bill Inman given the definition. So data warehouse definition that is very familiar. So and most of people use this definition only. So defined in many different ways, but not rigorously. So a decision support database that is maintained separately from the organization's operational database. So data warehouse is a decision support database. So it is not operational database. In this, we will not store day-to-day transactions. So it is the summarized database. It is only for the decision-making purpose. It is only for the analysis purpose. Okay, data warehouse, the main purpose is only it is for the analysis purpose and decision-making purpose. Manager level people only use the data warehouse. In data warehouse, large amount of data will be there. So from number of databases, data can be collected and put in a coherent source, in a single source, that is nothing but data warehouse. So data warehouse is mainly for the analysis. Day-to-day transactions, operational database transactions, those not stored in data warehouse. So it is a decision support system that is maintained separately from the organization's operational database. So see, in organization, so day-to-day transactions stored in the operational database, that is your relational database in the form of tables that you already know. In DBMS, you have seen. So the day-to-day transactions we will store in table, each and every item purchased in supermarket, that just a record can be entered, a row can be entered. So that is operational database. This data warehouse is entirely different. In data warehouse, the data is in summarized form, combined form. So it is integrated from multiple databases. So multiple databases, that data is taken and stored in data warehouse. In data warehouse, the data is a subject oriented, means only one particular subject at a time. In data warehouse, the data is related to only one subject. So and it is not at all changeable. So if you want to change the data, so you can do the changes in database itself, so operational database itself. Once you store data in data warehouse, you cannot change the data. So the database is the operational database, in that the changes are allowed. So you can change the data. So you can any rows you want to, records you want to delete, you can delete the records. You may update the values. You may insert the values. Transaction you can enter, insert. So that can be done in database, but that cannot be done in data warehouse. In data warehouse, once you store the data, that is fixed, that will not be changed. Okay. So that is the data warehouse. Though both are completely different. Support information processing by providing a solid platform of consolidated historical data for analysis. See here, data warehouse is support information processing by providing. So only 29 members attended again. Okay, so please intimate through your personal WhatsApp group. Just intimate to join immediately. So why? Because so from today onwards, I will take up to 11:20 only. Clearly, I follow the instructions. In yesterday's meeting, we restricted to that. Just we have to take only 50 minutes. So that is more than the time if you take a num, that is inconvenience for you. Okay, so that way I strictly follow the rules. Just through your WhatsApp personal group, just you intimate to other people, just join immediately. Next, support information processing by providing a solid platform of consolidated historical data for analysis. So a data warehouse supports information processing. The information means that is not data. Both are different. So information is nothing but the data required data. So in the data, large amount of data which is required. So that processed data is nothing but the information. So that by providing solid platform historical data for analysis. Okay, so data warehouse is it is a platform of consolidated. So the data is consolidated here. That means combined here. Okay, next is historical data. The data in data warehouse is historical. That means the data in data warehouse that may be 3 months, 6 months, 1 year or 5 years or 10 years, it may vary. Okay, so the data in data warehouse is a historical data. So it is then we can easily analyze from historical data. We can analyze. So the this is where various definitions are there. So data warehouse, but most of the persons prefer this definition. Data warehouse is a subject oriented, integrated, time variant, and non volatile collection of data in support of management's decision making process. This is the definition given by W. H. Inman in 1990. So previous definitions also same meaning. So but here the definition given in a clear format, and the words are technical words are very strong. So and each and every word you have to explain. So data warehouse is a subject oriented. First, subject oriented means what is meant by subject oriented? So that we will see. Subject oriented means organized around major subjects such as customer, product, sales, like that. Different subjects. A subject oriented, a particular subject oriented data warehouse is a subject oriented. So it may be related to customers, it may be related to products, it may be related to sales, like that. It is a subject oriented data focusing on modeling and analysis of data for decision makers, not on daily operations or transaction processing. Okay, it is mostly focusing on data warehouse, mostly focusing on analysis purpose only, decision making purpose only. So it is for decision making purpose only. It focuses on analysis and decision making, not on daily operations, daily transactions. For daily operations, daily transactions, we will use databases, operational databases that you have seen in DBMS subject. Those are nothing but the tables, relational model tables. Those you will use for transaction processing. Those you will use for daily operations. So you will not use this data warehouse for daily transactions. It is a only for summarized form, consolidated data stored in this. So and once the data stored in data warehouse, it will never change. So any changes you want to make to the data, so you can do the changes in database itself. So once you stored in data warehouse means that is not changeable. Provide a simple and concise view around particular subject issues by excluding data that are not useful in decision support process. Okay, so it is a simple and concise view around a particular subject issues. It is related to only a particular subject issues. So particular subject it is related to. So a data warehouse, employee data warehouse are customer related data, product related data, sales related data. So a particular subject, it is around a particular subject. So excluding data that are not useful in decision making process. So the data which is not useful decision making process, which is not useful for analysis, that data will not store in data warehouse. In data warehouse, which data stored? So only data stored, that data will be useful for analysis. That data useful for decision making. Those data only we will store in data warehouse. Okay, so that is subject oriented. Data warehouse is a first one, subject oriented. That is subject oriented. Next, integrated. So integrated means combining. So data warehouse is a combination of data, combination of data. So from multiple sources, from multiple databases, from heterogeneous databases, different databases, the data can be taken and stored in data warehouse. It is constructed by integrating. Integrating means combining, merging. Okay, so combining multiple heterogeneous data sources. Multiple heterogeneous means different data sources. Data is taken from different data sources, multiple data sources. So all those data can be combined. So and then it is stored in data warehouse. The data warehouse is stored by integrating, combining multiple different data sources, data from multiple different data sources. That is examples are from where data can be taken and stored in data warehouse means relational databases. Relational databases mean those are nothing but the tables. Next, flat files. The data can be taken from flat files. Online transaction records. So online databases are available. So online transaction records are there. So that means in ATM you are you are drawing money, so you are in deposit machine, you are depositing some money. So those all are online transactions. So you can do phone pay, okay, next Google Pay you are using daily. So those all are nothing but the online transactions. So these online transactions, from these online transaction records, so flat files, relational databases, means tables, from all these data can be taken and stored in data warehouse. Data cleaning and data integration techniques are applied on the data. So data the data stored in data warehouse, before that, so we will apply data cleaning technique and data integration technique. Okay, ensure consistency in naming conventions, encoding structures, attribute measures, etc. among different data sources. So already we have seen, previously we have seen the consistency among in naming conventions. So integration means here you are combining two different databases. In two different databases, the same column can be given as different names, student ID. So in the other database, that is given as student roll number. So both names are different, attribute names are different. So but the values are nothing but roll numbers, your roll numbers. Student first table 1 to 30, second table 31 to 60, your roll numbers, both are your roll numbers only. So one table it is given as student ID, one table it is given as student roll number. So both are same, so but attribute names are different. So this is one problem during integration. So and the other one is hotel price, such as currency. So in one table, in one table your price mentioned in rupees, in other table price mentioned in dollars. Okay, if you are doing a course in Coursera or any other course, if you enrolled edu skills or any other, okay, international international websites, if you international certification, for certification, they will display the price as dollars. Okay, 70 means $70, that is. Okay, so in different databases, here also the same. So different databases, two different databases having a price. So that price, one table it means rupees, in other table price means dollars. If you both combine, so that is the currency, the bit in two tables, so the measurement is different. Okay, so measuring is also one problem during integration. So the currency $100, 100 rupees, both are entirely completely different. So that is also one problem during integration. Data warehouse is a integrated data, so combining from multiple databases. So multiple, these are flat files, these are relational databases, data can be taken from, so and online transaction records, from all these data can be taken and stored in a unique form, that means stored in a single form. So different forms, price means in one, for example, price, it is stored in one table, it is stored in rupees, in other table it is stored in dollars. So but in data warehouse, commonly it will be stored in dollars or rupees in a single form. Okay, so that is integrated. Next, time variant. So the time horizon for the data warehouse is significantly longer than that of operational systems. Time horizon is very longer than operational system. Why? Because in operational system, so we will store data daily, we will store the data. So transaction by transactions, we will store database used for day-to-day transactions. So that's why the database time limit, it is useful. Otherwise, it is useful, accessible only up to 6 months or 1 year, like that. But data warehouse, so it is a long time data. The data in data warehouse is stored. So it is stored about 5 years, 10 years of data, 20 years of data we can store in data warehouse. Data warehouse is a historical data. The name itself indicates. Data warehouse is a historical, means time variant, time changeable. So operational database means here the current value data. So the current data, so present data stored in operational database. Data warehouse data means provide information from a historical perspective, past 5 to 10 years. So this month consolidated report I will place in data warehouse. Next month consolidated report, consolidated data only placed in data warehouse. So that's why the data warehouse data is historical data. So it is a time variant. Data warehouse is a time variant. Past 5 to 10 years, 20 years data we can store in data warehouse. Every key structure in the data warehouse contains the element of time explicitly or implicitly. Why? Because every key structure in data warehouse contains an element of time. Why? Because data warehouse is mainly for the analysis purpose, for the decision making. That is based on time only. So year-wise analysis, month-wise analysis. Okay, so or past 5 years data analysis report, but 10 years data analysis report. So that's why here the key element is time. Next, but key of operational data may or may not contain time element. So operational data that may or may not contain time element. Why? Because day-to-day transactions we will store, that is used for the operational database, used for store the data or updating the data or deleting the data. So those all transactions can be done on operational data. So that's why the key element may or may not time. So that is a time variant in data warehouse. So it is a historical data. The time varies. Past 5 years data you can store, 10 years data you can store, you can take 3 months data if you want, you can take 6 months data if you want, you can take 12 months data if you want. That's why it is a time variant. Data warehouse is a time variant. Data warehouse is a non-volatile. So volatile means changeable. Non-volatile means not changeable. In data warehouse, we will store the data means the data is stored, that is fixed. The data will be never changed in data warehouse. A physically separate store of transformed from the operational environment. So a physical separate store. So the data stored in cubes. Here in data warehouse, the data is stored in the form of cubes. Physically, that is different. In database, the data will be stored in the form of tables. Relational model, the data is stored in the form of relations or tables. Here, that is physically separate, data cube. Data cube means that is a cube representations we will see later. That in the data warehouse, the data is stored in the form of 3D format. So that is three-dimensional, that is cube. Operational update of data does not occur in the data warehouse environment. So update of data does not occur in the data warehouse environment. Updation so will not allowed. So already we discussed that operational data environment, in operational database only updations allowed. Here in data warehouse, updations not allowed. Does not require transaction processing, recovery, concurrency control mechanisms. Data warehouse not at all require all these. So why? Because the data will not change. So that's why recovery process, concurrency control process, those are not necessary. Only warehouse mainly for the analysis purpose. The data once stored means it will never change. Then what is the need of this recovery, transaction processing, concurrency control? No need. So these are all techniques, all mechanisms you need in operational databases. These mechanisms you studied in a DBMS subject, database management, you studied that. Transaction management, this transaction processing, so these recovery schedules, concurrency control mechanisms, these all you have studied in database management systems. In data warehouse, these will not require. Requires only two operations in data accessing. So that is here only two operations required, initial loading of data and accessing of data. So in data warehouse only just we will store the data and we will access the data. Store month-wise you will store, or week-wise just you will consolidated data, you will store in the data warehouse, and 10 years, 20 years data you will store like that. Any time if you want the data, just you will access the data. So just loading up the data and accessing of the data. Only two operations in data accessing that can be applied on data warehouse. So that is the definition of data warehouse. So data warehouse is a subject oriented, integrated, time variant, non-volatile collection of data in support of. So what is the purpose? In support for management's decision making process. This is only for the purpose of decision making process. So this is useful for management level people only. Okay, manager level people only. So this is the data warehouse definition. next applications. What are the different applications of data warehousing or data warehouse applications? So one is the financial services. So financial services means money related. So services, for those services, the transactions, money transactions, those can be stored in data warehouse. So for financial services, it can be useful, and banking services. In bank, number of persons' accounts can be maintained. Number of customers are bank customers are there. Those all persons' transactions, transaction completed, the data is fixed and stored in data warehouse. For banking services also, it will be useful. Next, consumer goods. Consumer goods goods means daily used items storage. So that daily used items products storage purpose also, we will use the data warehouse. Those details we will store in data warehouse. Next, retail sector. Retail sector means just purchasing goods from manufacturers and sold it to the customer. So just from customers to manufacturers, the mediators are the retail field. So that retail sector also we can use a data warehouse. Controlled manufacturing. So manufacturing control based on need. So manufacturing can be controlled by using this data warehouse. We can analyze and we can control the manufacturing. So these are the applications of the data warehouse. Next, OLTP versus OLAP. So online transaction processing versus online analytical processing. So online transaction processing means data basis. Online analytical processing means data warehouse. So what are the differences? So first, OLAP, OLTP. OLAP means data warehouse. OLTP means operational databases. Data warehouse, it involves historical processing of information. In data warehouse, we will store only historical data, summarized data. OLTP, online transactional processing, it involves day-to-day processing. Daily transactions, we will store in operational database. Next, second point, OLAP systems are used by knowledge workers such as executive managers and analysts. OLAP, data warehouse used by manager level people, knowledge worker. So knowledge means that is from scratch data, how the knowledge can be derived. You studied in KDD process, knowledge derived from data, KDD process. So that is the final knowledge can be represented in graphs, charts, bar charts, pie charts. Using that, the knowledge can be represented. So this knowledge, what is the purpose of this knowledge? This whom the people require, which people require this knowledge representation? Only the decision making. So that is management level people. So that's why the knowledge, finally, the knowledge used by OLAP systems only. The knowledge workers are the persons who worked on knowledge means executives, managers, and analysts. Those only use OLAP systems, data warehouses. OLTP systems. OLTP systems are nothing but the online transactional, day-to-day transactions, those database. Who will use the database means, one, clerks use the database. Next, database administrator. Database administrator means just monitoring the database. No? So the database administrators will use database professionals. Database professionals, they have to resolve the problems regarding databases. That's why database professionals also use the OLTP systems, that is database systems. So these are the executive managers and analysts. These are the database administrators, clerks, database professionals. Next. It is used to analyze the business. So data warehouse is a main purpose is nothing but analysis, online analytical. The name itself indicates it is mainly for the analysis purpose, analyze the business. So OLTP means day-to-day transactions we will store. Day-to-day transactions means it is used to run the business. Daily transactions, that means running the business. Next, fourth, focuses on information out. So from data warehouse, just it focuses on information out. So we will extract the information from data warehouse. So that is the OLAP main, focuses on information out. So why? Because just stored in historical format, consolidated format, what we can do? Just we can access the data. So we can access the information. So it is the information, it focuses on information out. So daily transactions means just we will enter the data. It focuses on data in. OLTP focuses on data in. We will store the data, transaction by transaction, we will store in database. It focuses on data in. Next point, it is based on star schema, snowflake schema, and fact cancellation schema. So these are the different representation mechanisms used for data warehouse. So these using these mechanisms, we will combine different schemas. That is in star shape, that is a star schema, snowflakes shape, that is snowflake schema, like that. So just we will see later these different representation techniques. These representation techniques are for data warehouse only. So it is based on ER model, entity relationship model. For database, what you will use entity relationship model. So before relational model, what you studied in DBMS subject, you studied entity relationship model. Each and every entity in ER model that can be converted into table. So student studying in college, student is an entity, college is an entity, studying in is a relationship. Employee works in department, employee is an entity, department is an entity, works in is a relationship. So this employee entity is converted into table. Next, department entity, works in department, department entity is converted into table, works in, the relationship is also converted into a table. So that's why it is based on ER model, entity relationship model. So each and every table that comes from an entity, so each and every attribute is nothing but column here. In a table, student ID, student number, student age, student marks, these are attributes. Attributes there, those are nothing but columns in relational model. That's why it is based on ER model. Next, it focuses on information out. Next term, that is a data warehouse. Database means it is application oriented. So database we can use for different applications. This is mainly for the application oriented. It contains historical data. So data warehouse is a historical data. It contains historical data. It contains past 5 to 10 years data, means that is historical. Next, OLTP means it contains the current data. So day-to-day daily transaction store means it contains the current data. Next, it provides a summarized and consolidated data. So we will store only the data in the form of summarized, combined form, summarized form, consolidated form. We will store the data in data warehouse. That's why it provides the data only. So what we are storing, consolidated data we are storing. So what we can get from data warehouse, it provides the summarized consolidated data. Next, database, it provides primitive and highly detailed data. So that means it is highly detailed, it provides. That means in particular hour, in particular minutes, what are the transactions done? So that can be given by operational database. Daily transaction, day-to-day transaction, in a particular time, so what are the transactions made? So that data we can get from database. It provides summarizes and multidimensional view of data. Data warehouse provides summarized multidimensional. It contains the data in data warehouse stored in the form of cubes. Cubes contains how many dimensions? 3 dimensions. That's why it is multidimensional view of data. Data warehouse is a summarized multidimensional view of data. It provides a detailed and flat relational view of data. Databases provides detailed and flat relational view of data. So this is the detailed. So that data in database is detailed. So under flat relational view, so that is only 2 dimensional. So column, row, only detailed view. So that is relational view of data it provides. Next, the number of users is in hundreds. Data warehouse, the number of users are hundreds. The number of users for database are thousands. Because users, number of users, day-to-day transactions that can be used by number of users are thousands. Many clerks works on that. In a supermarket, many clerks works on database. Many database administrators are there, database professionals also use the database. That's why users are thousands. Here, data warehouse means only the analysis purpose, only the decision making purpose. So the high level people, management level people only need this. That's why users are in hundreds. Next point, the number of records accessed is in millions. In data warehouse, the number of records accessed is millions. Why? Because in data warehouse, the main purpose is analysis. How the analysis can be done, how the decision making will be done based on the data accessing. So once the data access, then only we can analyze. Based on the analysis only we can make the decision. So it is a step by step process. The main for decision making, analysis is needed. For analysis, accessing is needed. So that's why accessing, the main purpose of data warehousing is just accessing the data. So number of records accessed are millions. Here in database, number of records accessed are only tens. Only very less number of records can be accessed. Okay. Why? Because just it is more to concentrate on data inserting. Data inserting, data updation, that's it. Okay. Database size is from 100 GB to 100 TB. Data warehouse, large amount of data, 10 years, 20 years of data stored. So that's why the database size or data warehouse here, the data warehouse size is 100 GB to 100 TB, very large. Here, the database size is from 100 MB to 100 GB. Only it is maximum up to 100 GB. So it starts from 100 MB. So why? Because day-to-day data, we will store daily transactions, so day-to-day operations we will store means very small amount of space is needed. That is enough. 100 MB to 100 GB, that's enough. Here, 100 GB starting, minimum 100 GB data warehouse, maximum 100 terabytes. So that more space is required for data warehouse. Why? Because large amount of data we are storing. Next point, these are highly flexible. So data in data warehouse is highly flexible. Next, it provides high performance. Data in database is high performance. So we can do any operation, any changes. That's why it is highly performance. It provides high performance, we can say. So that is already we discussed the same things based on different points. What is the difference that we will see here? So users for OLTP, clerks, IT professional, database administrators, database professionals, these are OLTP users. Next, OLAP means knowledge workers, managers, executives, okay, analysts, all these. Day-to-day operation stored in OLTP. Decision support will be stored in, decision support analysis can be done in OLAP. Database design. Here, OLTP application-oriented it is. Here, OLAP subject-oriented. So data in OLTP, it is a current data, up-to-date information, detailed information, flat relational information, isolated information. Data in database is a isolated, acid properties, atomic, consistence, isolation, durability. That's why it is, the data is isolated. The current data only stored in database. Up-to-date information is available. So detailed information is available. The flat relational form, the data is in flat relational form. Next, OLAP means historical data, past 5 to 10 years, 20 years data. Summarized form, consolidated form, the data is in consolidated, combined form, multi-dimensions, the data is in OLAP, data warehouse is cube. Cube means three-dimensional, multi-dimensional. So that is integrated consolidated form. Uses, OLTP repetitive uses. So repetitively we will use. This is OLAP means analytical, means ad hoc. Okay, next accessing, read or write. Index hash on primary key. So from the table, what are the operations we can perform on the table? Write operation, read operation. So you can enter the data and access the data. Next, indexing you can done on primary key. Hashing also you can done on primary key. So primary key means it does not allow null values and repeated values. Next, here lots of scans. Accessing is here millions. In millions of records can be accessed. OLAP, lots of scans, unit of work, short, simple transaction. In database, short, simple transactions are there. Transaction management, we study that. Here, complex queries required. For OLAP, complex queries required. Records accessed are, here, OLTP, tens. Here, millions. Users, here, thousands. Many users are there for OLTP. Daily transactions are many users. Here, only management level people, hundreds only. Database size. 100 MB to 100 GB. Here, OLAP, 100 GB to 100 TB. Next metric, this is transaction throughput. So this is query throughput. This is mainly query performance. That means response. This is for the analysis. That's why the representation of knowledge is needed here in OLAP. So query throughput, query evolution. So this is needed in OLAP. Here only transaction throughput. Metric is transaction throughput. So this is the difference between OLTP and OLAP. Why separate data warehouse? So already we are having already OLTP databases, then why data warehouse means? So different functions and different data. So DBMS means tune for accessing max methods, indexing, concurrency control, recovery. Warehouse means there is complex OLAP queries, OLAP queries, multi-dimensional view and consolidation. For all these purpose, we need warehouse. Database only supports these above only. Indexing, concurrency control, in detail data, recovery methods. So this concentrated in DBMS. So in warehouse, it is tuned for online analytical processing. Complex OLAP queries we'll write in OLAP, we'll see in OLAP. Next, three-dimensional view, consolidated data, we will see. Different functions and different data. So missing data, data consolidation, data quality, these all are the different functions we will see in different types of data in data warehouse. Some data missed, so those data can be filled. Okay. Next, in operational data, it will not maintain this missing data field can be filled properly. So all these entire data will not be stored in database. Data warehouse stores the data. Data consolidation. Data warehouse means just aggregation, summarizing the data, consolidating there from heterogeneous sources. Data quality. So data cleaning, integration, transformation, reduction, these all can be applied on data warehouse. Then the quality data will come. When the quality data will come, then automatically the quality decisions will make. So that can be supported by data warehouse. That's why data warehouse is needed. Next, data warehouse architecture. So data warehouse architecture, here it is the data warehouse architecture. In the lower level, you can see operational databases, external sources. Various heterogeneous sources and operational databases are at the lower level, are at the first level. So, okay, that means different databases, temporal databases, spatial databases, spatio-temporal databases, sequence databases, like that, text databases, multimedia database, different databases. External sources, heterogeneous flat files are there, different heterogeneous sources are there. From those, the data can be taken. So those data can be extracted, cleaned, transform, load, refresh. All these operations can be performed. So from those data directly, the data cannot be stored in data warehouse. Already we studied. So those data from different data sources, databases, the data can be taken, extracted. So under cleaning, transformation can be applied, and then the data can be loaded and refreshing can be done in data warehouse. So that is the from lower level to bottom tier. So in bottom tier, here in data warehouse architecture, we are having three tiers: bottom tier, middle tier, top tier. Bottom tier means that is data warehouse. From data warehouse, to data warehouse, data where the data where it will come from different heterogeneous sources and different databases. Okay, so that is the bottom tier. Data warehouse server it consists of. Next, middle tier it consists of from the data warehouse, the data can be taken and it is represented in cubes. So this is the cube representation. Here 1, 2, 3, three dimension. Top view, front view, so on the side view. Three views are there. See here, three views are there. So in middle tier, the data is represented in data warehouse is in the form of cubes. Here OLAP server, the data is in the form of cubes. It consists of three dimensions: front view, top view, side view. Okay. Next, this is the middle tier. Top tier, it consists of the output. So from the data warehouse, from multi-dimensional, three-dimensional cubes, the data can be represented in the form of bars, tables, charts, pie charts, graphs, all these. Using all these, we will represent the data. So that is in top tier. So front-end tools can be used to represent the data. So using the front-end tools, we will represent the data in top tier. So that is query report analysis, query report that is a relational form, table form analysis. The analyzed data can be represented in this bar graph or pie charts. Data mining, that is represented in graphs. So this is the front end tools that the top tier consists of. This is the data warehouse architecture. So this is the data warehouse architecture. So in that, first the bottom tier, we will see in depth. First tier means bottom tier. Next middle tier, next top tier. Tier 1 means bottom tier. It is a warehouse database server that is almost always a relational database system. Okay, this consists of a data warehouse. The data comes from relational databases. Backend tools and utilities are used to feed data into bottom tier from operational databases or other external sources. So backend tools and utilities are used to feed the data from where the data will come to data warehouse. From bottom tier, it consists of data warehouse server. Okay, so for data warehouse, from where the data will come, from operational databases, this backend tools, utilities using that, the data come from operational databases and external sources, that has such as a customer profile information provided by external consultants like that. Example, different heterogeneous sources. These tools and utilities perform. So here the arrow is there now. So for bottom tier, so below bottom tier, we are having operational databases, external sources. From operational databases, external source to bottom tier, we are having arrow. That arrow is nothing but the backend tools and utilities. So what the purpose of that arrow that indicates backend tools and utilities? These tools and utilities perform data extraction, data cleaning, data transformation. That is, transformation is nothing but merge similar data from multiple sources into a unified form. We already discussed data has to be transformed. In one database, in dollars, in other database, if it is in rupees, if you combine, then you will get a problem. So that's why the data is in a single form, unique form, as well as load and refresh functions to update the data warehouse. So you will click load and refresh. So load and refresh is nothing but to update the data. This tier also contains metadata repository, which stores the information about the data warehouse and its contents. Okay. Here, metadata repository. Metadata means what is meant by metadata. So in bottom tier, you are having metadata repository, monitoring, administration, data marts. You are having all these. In that, what is meant by metadata? Metadata means in data warehouse, what you store the data, the data information. That in the data warehouse, if you store the customer information, so in that customer ID is in integer, so or character, where character. Customer salary is in the long int. Okay, so like the different data types. The data about data is nothing but the metadata. So metadata repository is nothing but the storage of metadata. Metadata means data about the data. What data you store in data warehouse? The data belongs to which data type? So data warehouse is the employee, for example, each and every attribute is which data type? So our name is character. So next, salary means a long int. Next, some performance means that is float or double. Next, employee address, where care, like that. Data about data, that is the metadata. Okay, so metadata repository which stores information about the data warehouse and its contents. So that is tier 1. Next, tier 2. Middle tier is an OLAP server that is typically implemented using either a relational OLAP model or multidimensional OLAP model. So middle tier OLAP server means here two OLAP servers we are having. One OLAP server is ROLAP, and that means relational online analytical processing, or multidimensional online analytical processing. Two types of OLAP servers are there, ROLAP, MOLAP. ROLAP means relational online analytical processing model. MOLAP means multidimensional online analytical processing. OLAP model, what is meant by first OLAP model, we will see. So OLAP model is a extended relational DBMS that maps operations on multidimensional data to standard relational operations. Okay, so what is meant by this OLAP model? So it is an extended relational DBMS. In DBMS, the data is in only table form. Table means two dimensional. Here in OLAP, the data is in data warehouse OLAP, the data is in cube format, three dimensions. Okay, front, side view, top view, that is a three dimensional. So three dimensional, it maps operations on multi-dimensional data to standard relational, standard table operations. For that, we will map this OLAP server operations can be mapped to standard relational operations, standard table operations. Multi-dimensional OLAP model, that is a special purpose server that directly implements multi-dimensional data and operations. Okay, so multi-dimensional data, three-dimensional data and its operations. That means some operations are, for example, here roll up, drill down, like that. Roll up means, for example, here four rows are there, na? So four rows are there. So in that four rows, front end, if you see, four rows, in each and every row, we maintained quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Sales you are representing. So quarter one you are having in OLAP, quarter one, quarter two you are having, quarter three, quarter four. So this is first one is the one area, second one is the in column wise, first one is Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, okay, next Bangalore. So four cities are there. So on row wise we are having quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Okay, those can be combined. Roll up means these can be combined. So in 1 year, that means for quarter one, in four cities, what is the sales we can get from this table? So we can roll up. Roll up means these are quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Four rows can be combined and these can be represented in a single row. So we can represent or not. Did you get my point? See here in OLAP, in front view, four rows are there. Na? Four rows, in each and every row, first row, quarter one. Sales can be maintained. Second row, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Quarter one means January, February, March, like that. Okay, we can roll up the data here. So in cube, for cube, we can apply roll up. Roll up means four rows can be combined and we can represent the data in a single row. So that is roll up. Like that, we can drill down. So that means year data that can be divided into quarters. Quarters data that can be again divided into months. Quarter to months, that is drill down. These operations can be performed on OLAP server. Okay, so these are the data warehouse operations we can perform on cube. Next, tier three, what we are having, top tier is a front end client layer which contains query and reporting tools. Tier three is only for the purpose of user purpose. User can the knowledge workers, those can analyze the data, those can take the decision by using this front end client layer. So front end final client layer, this is the tier three, that is the top tier, which contains query reporting tools. The data reports can be maintained here. Based on the data reports, decisions can be taken. The data can be analyzed. After the analysis, decisions can be taken. Okay, so and our data mining tools, trend analysis, prediction, and so on. These are all data warehouse models. From perspective of data warehouse architecture, we have following data warehouse model: virtual warehouse, data mart, enterprise warehouse. These all are data warehouse models. Okay, so these all are data warehouse models. In this diagram, we will see different data warehouse models. These are the three tiers we are having. So that is a bottom tier, that is data warehouse server. Middle tier, that is OLAP servers, relational OLAP server, multi-dimensional OLAP server. Top tier, that is the representation of data, query report, that is front client, front end client server, that is a front end client layer. Front end client layer, user directly interact and user directly can the data, directly can get the report. Okay, so that is the top tier, that analysis, data mining, query report, these all comes under top tier. Okay, this is about the data warehouse architecture. So if anyone having doubts, you can ask now.